Hi, welcome, welcome, welcome. Today is the last session of this summer of coding, and we have a couple of students who are ready with the their mini project that they have done after a 5-week course of summer of coding. So it was basically 3 classes per week, and approximately 18 sessions have been done, and they are right now done a mini project. Let's invite the first student who will be showcasing his project right now. So Shashank, you can come, you can start talking, you can tell about your experience about the course, and then you can also start talking about the project, what your project does, and execute the project, and then you can also explain about your code. Okay, go ahead, over to you, Shashank.
So first of all, the summer of coding, the name itself was new to me, and the classes were even more unique. First of all, the digital classes and the tutorials, that was different and unique, and the way you teach also is very important as well as specific. So the thing is, about my project, I have always loved planes. I want to be a pilot one day or an engineer, but sadly I'm bad at physics and math, so I'm trying my best at it. It just came to my mind that right now the airline industry is going down very badly because no one is traveling, of course, because of coronavirus. So the thing is, I don't know, I just clicked. I just wanted to make a software that could book flights. I made it for Emirates, and I wanted to make it a private jet.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Great.
Because, yeah. Yeah. Okay. 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 So basically,
Shashank, is it disturbing your parents?
My sister is sitting there. She's playing keyboard. I told her to reduce the volume.
Okay, fine. Go ahead.
Okay. So basically, I made a website. Not a website. A program that could book your flight. And then there's destination. I will be talking more on that during the explanation. So yeah, let's continue.
Yeah. Sure.
So I hope you can see my screen right now.
Yes.
Okay. So now I had calculated the number of, so this is my project. 1 minute. Okay. Oh, admit. So basically I've opened the terminal. 1 minute. Yeah. So I have done many projects, the same thing I had done it before, but it starts from here. So this is the start thing. So from here it says enter the serial number of the destination. So these are the destinations, it's like menu driven. So for now there's only 4 destinations. So there's Dubai, New York, Singapore and London. So thing is, say I want to go to Dubai because that's what is known for Emirates. So I just have to type serial number 1, enter. Then it'll ask for the date. The date, month, and the year of when you want to fly.
Just to request her just for a few minutes until your presentation. Just not to use the piano, right?
Okay, just 1 minute.
Yeah, just request her.
Yeah, okay. So now you can enter the date, month, and year. So say this is... So the first flights of Emirates is scheduled to be on June 2nd to Dubai. I just looked it up before the class. So the date is 2nd. And June, the number of June is 6. And the year is 2020.
Good.
So yeah. And now it asks you to enter the flight class, business class, first class, economy class. Based on this, your bill will be executed. So serial number of the class below. So just for the sake of the program, I want to take business class because last time I entered serial number 1, This time I will enter serial number 2. So that is business class. Although I won't want to fly in business class, I want to fly in first class.
Okay.
But still, business class, enter. So you get a flight ticket that is given to you when the program is completed. So the flight ticket, and then it says your destination is serial number 1. So you can go up and look. Okay, yeah, I booked for Dubai. And then now I can say your flight time is 14 hours and 15 minutes from Bangalore to Dubai. This video is recorded in Bangalore, and I have programmed this to be start to start in Bangalore. Flight to start in Bangalore. And then to enter your class 2, serial number 2, and which is basically business class. You can just look it up here. And then because it's business class, I programmed it to give a bus driver's number. So I've just written it some random number. So I've just told the user to inform him when to pick you up based on your travel date and time. And then it just shows your travel date, which is 2/6/2020. You can look that up as you just entered it out here. So this is just a confirmation. In the bill ticket, it just shows you everything, and then it says thanks for choosing Emirates. Next customer, please. So this basically, I thought I would put it in an airport and not in a computer, so that it could repeat. You go to the next customer. So oh, yeah, that's the thing.
Wonderful, awesome, great. You want to showcase the code?
Yes, of course. Okay. I did a lot of work in coding, so why not?
Excellent.
So this is a 300 line code.
Oh, wow.
That I wrote yesterday night.
Okay.
So the thing is, first of all, import Java utils. So this is just number println, the destinations and all that. And then there's flight class, and then it asks for the serial number of the preference. And then it takes in the variable, as you can see here, it's prompt and accept from the user. Mm. Then it prints out the flight ticket for class 1, if class is equal to 1. Mm. If class is equal to 2, it'll print this ticket.
Okay.
So the thing is, if it prints class is equal to 1, you have to see this detailed difference that I've done. I've made this a taxi driver and not a bus driver. So it basically means you get a private taxi to the airport. So that's one bonus that you get.
Okay.
And number again is just random.
Okay.
And then for business class, you get bus driver. And for economy class, you mind your own transport because we cannot provide for what for the thing. Yeah, the same thing has been executed again and again.
Okay.
For different destinations. The reason I did a for loop for the destinations is because I want to execute the flight time.
Okay.
If I didn't want to execute this flight time, I would have just said, I would have also put this destination in an if-else statement.
Great.
So yeah, this is my code. It's 300 lines long.
Excellent.
I want to highlight that it's 300 lines long.
Awesome, Shashank. Thank you so much. Shashank, you can also introduce about yourself, which grade you are in.
Oh, okay. I should have.
No problem.
So
you can
basically,
do it.
I am in grade 8, moving to 9th now. Basically, we are in the corona lockdown, which is a very fun period.
Okay.
Although we can't go out.
Okay,
so I am moving from 8th to 9th. I'm studying Greenwood High International School.
Great.
And my name is Shashank Balaji. Yeah.
And how was your experience learning from last 1 month, the entire summer of coding classes?
The thing was, it was based in steps. So first of all, the slideshow that you had made was very intriguing, I should say, because I don't know, it's just fun to look at.
Which slide? Yeah. Which slideshow are you talking about?
About the syntax and the how it works and all. I understand that you had spent a lot of time before making that slideshow, because that's something I really appreciate.
Okay.
Because most teachers don't do that. They just come onto the say class and then show a Word document from the internet.
Okay, fine. Yeah. So I spent 10 months in creating the slides. So these slides I actually took 10 full months in 2014, and I created this for the students so that it's very easy for the children to understand. Thank you for recognizing that. So you feel that you have moved from you knew a little bit of Java, and then now you have moved forward. Do you feel that?
Yes, of course. So the little bit of Java I knew, it was unordered. So once you had introduced comments, that really changed how I program.
Okay.
What I was taught in school was just, it was just like the code executed, and sometimes we used to write the code in just one line. Okay. Some of the codes in one line.
Great. Thank you so much.
Find and change all of that. And then, so when you introduced comments and structured programming, it really made life easier.
Okay.
Programming life easier.
That's nice. Awesome. Thank you so much, Shashank.
Welcome. So it's an honor to be in your course.
My pleasure. Next, who wants to go next? Next, I told Aditya. Aditya? Do you want to come? You can switch on your webcam if you have.
Yeah. Hi, sir.
Hi. Pleasure to see you. Yes, go ahead, Aditya. So, like how Shashank shared his project, you can also go about, introduce yourself. What is your project? Introduce about your project. Then execute the project. Then explain your code. And then you can share your experience at the end.
Yeah. So my name is Aditya Thorat. I'm from Mumbai. So when my mom was, I think she was on Facebook and all. At that time, she found your course. So even I was interested in coding. But it was little unordered because I didn't know. I just know that they would make games. From childhood, I'm a gamer kind of, means I love playing games.
Oh, nice.
So means like my mom told that, means like just playing games, it is better you make games. Then I also thought that she is telling right only, because means it is a work which everyone will appreciate.
Definitely.
If we play games, no one is going to appreciate, but who make it, they will appreciate him.
Definitely.
We appreciate the maker of the game. Sir. So means in this way I got interest in coding. I learned very new at TechSparks here. So Java, it was something new to me.
Okay. And which grade are you in?
I'm in 8th, but means learning Java, means coding, okay, was new to me.
Okay.
So that's why I thought that something new in this lockdown would be a great opportunity to learn.
Excellent.
So that's how, this is my mini project. Now, we are all IPL fans and all, but now this and all IPLs are cancelled because of this COVID-19. So, yeah.
It's a good thing.
I thought that I will not make a game, but I thought we will make a scoreboard at least for cricket.
Wow.
I didn't remember it.
Wow. Okay, go ahead. You can share your screen and then.
Yeah, so this is my.
So you can do it slowly because I understand that system is slow.
Yeah, so this is a scorecard for batsmen and all. And all. So first we'll choose a bowler name. So sir, you can choose a bowler name here. I'll type the number.
Bowler name, Shoaib Akhtar.
So which one?
Shoaib Akhtar, one bowler.
Okay. And batsman number, which batsman?
One, Sachin Tendulkar.
Yeah. And runs made by that batsman?
Of course, 6.
Yeah, so is he out or no?
No.
Okay, so here all the scoreboard will come and all.
Okay.
So you can even continue for the second over. It will go on.
Okay, so, nice. Excellent.
Yeah, but this thing, it is looking big, but it is kind of easy. Only a hundred, means something more than 100 codes were required for this.
Okay.
Not much and all. So that's why.
Yeah. Nice. How many hours did you take to develop this?
2 to 3 hours.
Good. Good. Excellent. Yeah, you can show the code explanation.
Yeah, so all these codes were there, public word display data and all.
Okay.
And public class cricket here, and I put all the names here.
Okay.
And system, so the system.println means it almost changed everything, because even the system.println was making something very huge difference here, because it obviously prints the next line and all.
Right, right.
Yeah, so here all the numbers are there. And some things were even based on maths also. Only to some one, two statements only.
Okay.
So it is all of this 125 line of program here.
Okay, great. Great. Very good. Awesome, Aditya.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now I'll stop sharing this.
Yeah, thing. You can share your experience. How was the entire month course? And then how was your experience? You can just share. Yeah,
sir. So firstly, I would like to thank you, because I made my first game with your help only. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah, the game was loved by all my family also.
Ah.
Yeah, that I showed you also.
Yeah, you want to share your game? You can share it right now if it is there.
The guest number one.
Yeah, yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah, so, okay. Yeah, so actually, I named the game again. I put it Try Your Luck.
Excellent.
It is all based on luck only. This
yes,
game.
Yes, it's gambling.
Yeah. Yes, wait, something is running here.
Yeah. So, just restart the JVM, right bottom. Right bottom, you can just press restart.
Yeah.
U-turn button.
U-turn.
The world is going in U-turn only now.
So now I'll start screen sharing.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. And this is Try Your Luck game.
Okay.
So this is level 1. Enter your guess between 1 to 6. So we get chance one, so I think it's 4. It will tell you no worries, you still have 2 more chances, but we actually have 3 chances in this game.
Okay.
It will be either 5 or 6, because in this range we have 2 chances and 2 numbers left. So yeah, that is all luck. So I win 5000 here.
Okay.
And now according to the level, if it is level 2, then the range will also increase, because no one's gonna give you so many easy levels. They don't want to become bankrupt and all. So,
okay.
Yeah, so this will be think a little very. So, ten. Think a little lower. So, it can be 7, 8, 9. Yeah, this is actually a bit dangerous. Yeah, actually, I won 2000 now. And as it is level 3, so the range will increase, as I told you. There are 10 levels in this game.
Excellent.
It depends on us how much levels we want here. So, actually, I will go according to the number set. So, I can choose 9, means I can get an idea. So, it is lower case, so 5. So, it is not 9, not 5. So, it will be 6, 7, 8. So, it could be 7. Okay, so I have money. So it is 10,000, yeah. So it will be again, and as I told you, levels, so this range has increased. So it is from 1 to 24. So I'll directly go on 20. It is telling a little lower, so now it is kind of tough here. think a little lower. So then lower than this will be 11. Okay, now the game will also insult you. They will tell you, no worries, please go home. Lucky number one time.
Okay.
And, it will sum the prize money. Means how much prize money you have won.
Okay. Oh, excellent, excellent. Awesome, Aditya. Wonderful. Thanks for sharing this.
Yeah.
Someone has been too lucky today.
10,000 rupees.
I can buy a new laptop with that.
So actually, in this this COVID-19 this position means there is nothing left at home to do. Because watching TV continuously, playing games on phone will not help you. And plus, only schools are there. It was making it worse. But now schools are not there. But at that time, this Java program came and it almost changed my life. So now I'm in a position. I can make game. I can make a calculator.
Yeah.
And make a calendar also.
Wow.
So it is very nice to learn from you, sir.
Awesome.
Yeah, sir. It is very nice actually. I'm learning this. I do not have words to say now.
Wow. That's nice. Awesome. Great, Aditya. I think you had computer system challenges also, but you were able to manage it.
Yes.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you, Aditya.
Yes, sir. Welcome.